So before I'm going to start today's lecture, maybe I can introduce myself. I'm one of the lecturer at Universitas Erlangga, of course, and I'm also teach about the nutrition education with Mr. Trias, with Pak Trias. I'm graduated from Universitas Indonesia and Mahidol University Thailand in 2016, and then I've worked for 5 years now at Universitas Erlangga. So my name is Konita Rahmah, but you can call me Nita or Konita. And today I'm going to explain a bit about the developing objective and also effective message in nutrition education. So if I'm not mistaken, did Pak Trias give you a final assignment to develop nutrition education, online nutrition education maybe, or not?
Yes.
Okay. Can you explain about the assignment? Because today's lecture might be beneficial to, to develop your final assignment, because we are going to talk about the objective and how to develop effective message. So here's the learning outcome for today's lecture. So we hope from this lecture you can develop nutrition education objectives, design nutrition education message, and also you can motivate your audience in nutrition education. So here's the figure that shows a step in designing theory-based nutrition education. As you can all see here, first you have to decide what kind of issues that you want to address. For example, you can choose something related to child obesity or related with maybe anemia among girls, adolescent, and many others nutrition issue. There are so many nutrition issues that you can choose as one of the objective. And after decided the major issues of the nutrition education, then you have to choose a target behaviors. What kind of target behavior do you want to change? Is it a self-efficacy? Is it only knowledge that you want to improve, or many others behaviors? And then you choose the mediator for behavior, and then the theory that you want to do. Whether you want to focus using transtheoretical model or social cognitive theory or even health belief model, it's all up to you as the nutrition educators. And one important thing in designing theory-based nutrition education is this step four, state the objective. So what kind of objective that you want to achieve through this nutrition education? So there are two terms, goals and objective. These are two different things. Okay, and we are going to talk more about the objective, but not the goal. Can you or anyone can maybe explain, or do you have any idea what's the difference between goal and objective? Anyone? What is goal and what is objective? Is it different or is it the same? Actually, goal and objective are two different things. Yeah. So from this picture itself, you can maybe imagine that goal is something that bigger than the objective. But in order to get the goal, you need to have some objectives. It could be more than one, could be more than two, or even more than five. It's depend on what kind of goal that you want to achieve. So here's the picture. You can understand about the difference between goals and objectives. So usually goal is something that are still broad, abstract, and intangible. And in order to get the goal, you need to have several objectives. Objective 1, objective 2, objective 3, and maybe objective 10. It depends on what kind of goal that you want to achieve. And if we talk about the objective, there's several things that we have to consider when we develop the objective of nutrition education. The objective should be SMART. SMART means specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. So these variables, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, or time-bound, or we can call it as SMART, is something that makes our objective better. Yeah. So it is also applicable in nutrition education. We have to be able to develop a SMART objective, not just objective like, for example, to increase self-efficacy. It's not a SMART objective. Okay. So what is SMART means here? Sorry. Specific should be able to answer who is the target audience. And also, what do you want to achieve? Okay, wait. Okay, and then measurable should be able to answer several questions. Can the objective be measured? How to measure it? And how many change that can be achieved? For example, if you want to increase the knowledge of the specific population, then you have to be able to answer how can you measure the knowledge of your participant. Is it through the questionnaire? Is it through question and answer session or many other tools? Okay, so an objective should be measurable. And then the A stands for achievable. Is the objective possible to achieve, and are the resources support to achieve that objective? For example, again, I use the example of increasing knowledge of specific population, because increasing knowledge is one common objective for nutrition education. Yeah. So for example, I want to increase the knowledge of a specific population, then I want to increase the knowledge for a day, for example. Now, you can think yourself, is it possible to increase someone's nutrition knowledge in just one day? Especially if you want to increase several knowledge, for example, related with obesity, what type of obesity, how can obesity happens, and many other things. So the more topic that you want to deliver to your target, the longer time needed to do the nutrition education as well. Okay, because it is not possible to achieve specific objective only in a few days. So you have to think about that when you design the objective of your nutrition education. Is it possible to achieve or not? Resources, it include the human resources and also another resources, for example, educational materials and many other related with the nutrition education, so that it can be done in a specific time frame. The next one after specific, measurable, achievable. The next one is sorry. Is relevant, Yeah, so is it suitable with the objective? Will it affect the success of the program? You have to consider it as well. And the last one is time. So when you develop the objective of nutrition education, you also need to think that the objective should be achieved within a certain time. So you have to also decide the period of the nutrition education. I think I gave you some example previously that I want to increase the nutrition knowledge of maybe school children related with the intake of fruits, vegetables for 1 month, for example. Yeah, so you have to put the time frame when you develop or write the objective for nutrition education. I think it's quite easy to remember the objective. It should be SMART, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time bound. Okay. So here's the example of the difference between goal and also objective. Yeah, so goal is something that is broad and it's abstract. Yeah, healthy diets. Healthy diets can be mean by many things, or everyone can have a different perspective about what they mean by healthy diets. But here the objective is more specific, yeah, about the food security and also about the nutrition education. Here specific about the nutrition education, the objective is people want to improve their diet, people know how to improve their diet, and people take action to improve the diet. I think it's related with the trans-theoretical model. Yeah, so we start making people want to change the behavior to improve the diet. And then after they want to improve the diet, then we tell them how to improve the diet. And then we encourage them to take action to improve the diet so that they can have a healthy diet. So in another words, I can say that goals is a long-term objective. Yeah, but objectives here is more shorter, or something that we can achieve in a shorter period. Here's also another example from Jomo's fruit tree. So he's a nutritionist, works at the Nutrition Institute, and he want to increase the fruits and vegetable consumption. And then he make a fruit tree, yeah, that define a goals and also objective for this specific issue. In the right part, you can see diagram A and diagram B. You can use either diagram A or diagram B to state the goal and objectives of the nutrition education. Diagram A is more like if you want to achieve one goal with a several objective, but diagram B is more specific. Yeah, so one goal, it can be done or it can be achieved by one objective. And one objective can be done by having some more sub-objective. So this is also possible because in one objective, we can also have another sub-objective. But I think in my point of view, diagram B is a bit more confusing than diagram A. So sometimes I more prefer to use the diagram A to state the goal and also objective for my nutrition education. So here's the areas of objective. It helps you to develop the objectives. Yeah, so there are three areas. Cognitive domain. Cognitive domain is more related with the knowing or thinking. I think in, I don't know in another country, but in Indonesia, during the high school or even since primary school, we always judge by the cognitive domain, our affective, and also our psychomotor. It is also works in nutrition education, yeah. So there are cognitive domain and also affective domain. Affective domain is more related with the attitude, feelings, emotion, and many others. And the last one is psychomotor domain, related with the skills. So if your nutrition education is only giving an example or maybe like giving an information related with the specific nutrition issues, then I think it's only limited to cognitive and maybe only maybe affective domain as well. But if you are include some activities, some hands-on activities in your nutrition education, then psychomotor domain can be also present. Yeah, for example, you want to have cooking demonstration to increase the skill of cooking fruits and vegetables, for example, then it's kind of psychomotor domain as an objective. Yeah, but if it's only, for example, putting some information in your Instagram, yeah, having a webinar related with nutrition issues, then it's only cognitive and affective domain, because there's no skills that you want to improve through that kind of nutrition education. Okay, so here the level of cognitive domain. Have you ever seen this pyramid? This is the level of thinking. If I'm not mistaken, is from Maslow theory. Yeah, if I'm not mistaken. So there are a level of thinking from knowledge to comprehension to application to analysis, synthesis, and also evaluation. That's the level of cognitive domain that you can achieve through nutrition education. But you have to remember that if you want to achieve the higher level of learning, level of thinking, then nutrition education should also need a longer period. Yeah, as I mentioned, if you want to increase knowledge, I think one or twice nutrition education will be enough. But if you want them to, if you want your audience to be able to evaluate, for example, evaluate their daily intake, for example, or evaluate their physical activity level, for example, then it cannot be done in only one or two times. Maybe it takes 1 month or even more than 1 month. Yeah. So knowledge described as recalling information as it is learned. Comprehension, reporting information. And then application, they can apply the learned information. Analysis, taking learned information so that it is organizational structure, may be understood. And then synthesis, they can put together parts and elements. Yeah, emphasize on creating new meaning of the structure. And last or the highest level of thinking is evaluation, making judgment about something related with nutrition. And here are the useful verbs that you can use to write the objective related with cognitive domain. For example, you want to increase knowledge of the specific population, you can write participants or school children can define the type of fruits and vegetables that high in vitamins, for example. Or in other words, for example, school children can list or can recall the type of fruits and vegetable that is good for their eyes, for example. Yeah, that's the example. Yeah, so you can use this useful verbs. I'm not going to read one by one, I think, because you can read it yourself here. Okay. The next one is the affective domain, is the level of engagement between you as a nutrition educators and the audience of nutrition education. The affective domain, levels of affective, The lowest level is receiving. Yeah, receiving means your audience paying attention to what you are going to say during the nutrition education session. And then responding, there are active participation for the audience. Yeah, for example, if you have a Q&A session and then they answer or they have active participation during the nutrition education, any kind of active participation, whether it is answering or they have a point of view, anything you can see during the nutrition education. And then after responding, more higher level is valuing. Valuing means that your audience have a behavior based on positive regard for something. Yeah, so they can demonstrate what you are explained, they can report, they can share information that you have given during the nutrition education. And then after valuing is organization. Organization is more higher yeah, than valuing because they can organize, they can you know, like they can put something or conceptualizing important values from nutrition education that you given. Some useful verbs that you can use in this level of engagement is organize. They can also arrange. For example, you want your audience to be able to arrange a meal plan during Ramadan. Healthy meal plan during Ramadan. Yeah, so it means that your nutrition education objective is in the level of organization. So they're not just paying attention, but in order to be able to organize, they have to pay attention first. Okay, I hope you can understand. And then the last one is internalizing value. Internalizing values mean that whatever you teach during nutrition education become a daily habit of your audience. Yeah, so behaving according to the consistent worldview. Yeah, some useful verbs, they can act, they can display, they can modify, influence, they can perform as well. So internalizing values, actually they already able to organize specific behaviors from the nutrition education, and then they put it into daily basis. So that means they are internalizing values of nutrition education that you have given. So that's the level of affective, similar to cognitive domain, yeah. Affective domain also, if you want to achieve the higher level of affective domains, means that you need a longer period of nutrition education. The last one is psychomotor domain. It's a level of skills. As I previously mentioned, that if you want to make psychomotor domain as one of your objective, then it's not limited to only giving a conventional education. So it's not just only lecture or webinar or, for example, education through Instagram or many other social media, but you also need to increase their skills related with nutrition. Yeah, level of performance in psychomotor domains, the lowest level was observing. It is when you have or you need your audience to observe some skill performance related with nutrition, yeah, of course. So they just observe or they just watch. For example, if you have a cooking demo or another hands-on activity, maybe you you have or you give an example how to make a nutritious sandwich to reduce anemia or to prevent anemia, for example. Yeah, you ask your audience to watch you or to observe. So there's the psychomotor domain there, but only in the level of observing. And then after observing is imitating. Imitating means you want your audience to follow instruction. Of course, it's under supervision. So for example, after you give them example how to make a healthy sandwich, and then you ask them to make their own healthy sandwich. Okay, and then higher level in psychomotor domain is practicing, means that they can practice in routine, yeah, so they can complete entire sequence repeatedly. They can carry out maybe for a week or 2 weeks or maybe a month. And then the last one is adopting, means that your audience is adapts or modified to improve outcome. Further means that to improve the nutritional status of your audience. Yeah, it's actually quite the same with the affective domain, yeah, between affective and psychomotor domain. But the difference is that if you input the psychomotor domain, then you need to give example first of the specific skills. The affective, you don't need to give example skills, but if psychomotor, then you need to give them or give your audience specific skills, how to make healthy sandwich, for example, or maybe how to cook fruits, how to cook vegetable to prevent nutritional loss, or example to do physical activity at home, for example, to increase their skill to do physical activity, and many other examples. Okay, so here's the example. Yeah, some example that I can give. For the first example, the objective is at the end of the program or session, nutrition education session, of course, the participant will be able to demonstrate the understanding that a diet high in fruits and vegetables reduces the risk of heart diseases and cancer. Yeah. It can be done, or you knew that they understand by correctly answering a questionnaire at the end of the program or session. So there are two domains of objective here, a cognitive and also affective. Cognitive means comprehension level, and affective is in responding level. Yeah. Okay, next example, it's a knowledge, yeah. Yeah, it's a very common objective in nutrition education. So you can also put increasing knowledge in your as one of your nutrition education objective. Knowledge here at the end of the program or session, the participants will be able to understand the dietary advice for reducing risk of cancer. How do we know that our participants understand how to reduce risk of cancer? Is by listing three of the relevant dietary guidelines without looking at the materials. So here's also the cognitive domain in the level of comprehension, not only knowledge, but in comprehension level. So it's a quite higher level than only knowledge. Another example, self-efficacy. Yeah, at the end of the program, the participant able to demonstrate belief in their ability to prepare foods lower in fat. How? By proposing bring a lower fat recipe to share with the group in the next session. So you can see from this example, yeah, from self-efficacy, that there will be next session. So it's not only one time, one-stop nutrition education. Okay, so that you can also see the self-efficacy and the cognitive and affective domain is also in quite higher level, cognitive in comprehension and affective in valuing level. Okay, so they can value, they can also write their own lower fat recipe. Actually, it can also, you can also put psychomotor domain here in the self-efficacy if previously we teach them how to make a lower fat recipe. Yeah. Okay, the next example is behavioral capabilities. Behavioral capabilities here, the example is Participants demonstrate the ability to stir fry vegetables by imitating demonstration in class by preparing identical dish at home. Yeah, so here's there are the psychomotor domain, imitation level, also cognitive comprehension. You can also put the affective domain actually. Yeah, what kind of affective domain that you think is suitable for the example number 3? Anyone? Okay, you can do it as your homework, yeah, maybe. What kind of affective domain that you can put here in the example 3. And then example 4, social support. Demonstrate the ability to share feelings about chosen diet with friends and family and to seek support group by asking family to support their own macrobiotic eating pattern. Macrobiotic eating pattern is actually one type of vegetarian diet, yeah, that is very strict, the most strict one amongst the vegetarian diet. So you can only eat specific type of fruits and vegetables. There are cognitive domain here, comprehension, and also affective domain is valuing level. I think valuing level as one of the affective domain can also be put in example number 3. Yeah. Okay, and here's the example of SMART objective. Yeah, SMART objective from each different type of domain in objective. Yeah, because you put 80% here, as I mentioned before, that SMART. Yeah. SMART objective should be specific and then measurable and others. And you can you put the measurable here. So I can decide that my nutrition education is success if 80% of the participant can differentiate the healthy and unhealthy complementary food after following a cooking demonstration. But it will be better actually if you put who is the participants here. So for example, 80% of the, I don't know, maybe housewife can differentiate. A housewife age 19 to 40 years old, it will be better if you put who is your participants here. Yeah, because it will be more specific objective. And then for affective also, yeah, 80%. Willing to prepare and psychomotor practicing 80%, able to prepare balanced meal for complementary food after 2 weeks following a cooking demonstration. Okay, so here's the example of SMART objective within each type of domain, cognitive, affective, and psychomotor. And I have to again remind you that In one-time nutrition education, it's not mandatory to put all three objective. You can also you can just put one or two. Maybe you just put cognitive and affective. That's okay. Or you just put cognitive. It is also fine. Or you can also put all of them in one nutrition education. So it's really depend on what kind of nutrition education that you want to do. Okay. Okay, now we are going to message. Does anyone has any questions maybe before I go to the next topic?
No questions so far.
No, madam.
Okay. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the message. So if we, I don't know what happened with this. Please wait. So before I continue to the next topic, have you ever maybe joined nutrition education, or have you ever seen any nutrition education in your, maybe in your neighborhood or in your social media maybe?
our courses in current university.
Oh, what kind of nutrition education?
We are taking nutrition and dietetic course.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes.
So what kind of nutrition education that they teach? What topic?
What topics? A lot. Example like how health belief model influence our intake, something like that.
Okay. Yeah, that's one of a good example, yeah. The implementation of nutrition education. So here's the, actually, when we talk about the message, you have to remember that three things. I don't know why the slide doesn't want to stop. The first one is, what does my audience know? And then what does my audience need to know? And what question will my audience have? It can help you actually to develop your message, because for example, if your audience is a participant with lower social economic status or lower educational level, then you have to make your nutrition education also suitable with them. Okay, I hope it doesn't move anywhere. Okay, so back to the topic of our message. So it is very important, yeah, to first understand your audience. So what my audience know, what my audience need to know, what's actually they want to know. Because if our audience doesn't think that they need that message, specific nutrition message, then they will ignore our nutrition education session. It often happens, yeah, in reality. If we don't assess our audience, what they know, and then, for example, their level of education, their level of social economic, that's just the example, and then we will make the nutrition education that is not suitable with their background. Yeah, so this is very important to know. And also, what question will my audience have? It's just, you know, as a preparation for you to learn before giving a nutrition education, because sometimes audience have a very very unique questions, if I might say, yeah, out of the box question that related with something that we try to deliver to them. So it's the three main questions that you need to gain, that you need to comply before develop a message in nutrition education. From the FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, they have several things to be considered if you want to develop a nutrition education message. First, you have to give the most important information first. Yeah, so what is the most important information? And sometimes, if you want to put the most important information, you can also use some things like, you know, like eye-catching or ear-catching if you use audiovisual media. Yeah, so it is important to attract them. Yeah, so give the most important information first. Why is it why it is important for them, and then how important the information that you want to share, so that it can engage your audience since the first time. Second one, the content should be clear and concise. Of course, don't put too many message, because it can confuse our audience, and most of the times they don't get what we are trying to say if we put too many message in one time of nutrition education. So you can limit the number of message, no more than 4 key messages. focus on what they need to know and what they need to do, stick to the one idea at a time, and avoid lengthy lists. Yeah, because nowadays, I think not many people wants to read something that is too long, yeah. So you have to avoid lengthy lists so that they can get the idea on what kind of message that you want, you try to say to them. And then the next one, you also need to clearly state the action that need to take. For example, you want to educate them on how to have a good hand washing. Yeah, so you need to put step by step as clear as possible what kind of action they have to do first. For example, they have to put the foam, and then second step, third step, and other step until the last step. And don't forget to highlight the positive if they are doing hand washing regularly, especially for example in this COVID-19 pandemic, yeah, and many other things. So highlight the positive can also increase the curiosity of the audience, and they will motivate to follow our message during the nutrition education. And then another message should be able to tell the audience what they will gain from understanding and using the material. You can also use a scare tactic, yeah. Scare tactic means, or fear tactic means, that you give them something that is scary in order to increase the willingness of your audience in listening to your nutrition education. For example, if you want to educate them about the danger of smoking, okay, for the example, and then at the first or the second slide, you put the picture of people with the cancer, yeah, because of smoking behavior. So it's the one type of fear or scare tactic that you can use in beginning the nutrition education message. Because sometimes, especially in Indonesia, yeah, I think specifically in Indonesia, most of the audience are ignored with the healthy diets. Yeah, but now if I said that if you did not do the healthy diet, that you can infect, you can get COVID-19 infection. It's also a scare tactic. You scare them so that they want to start a healthy diet. Okay. And then number 6, choose your words carefully. Keep it short. Communicate with a natural tone and easy to understand. It is very important. It's very important, especially if your audience are children, yeah, or adults in lower economic status or lower educational level. Sometimes they don't understand with the nutrition terms, yeah. So you have to be able to communicate it with another words, yeah, maybe using examples. And then respect and value your audience, yeah, especially if your audience have specific taboos, yeah, or something related with religion, maybe. We should respect that value. And use a tone that encourage, emphasize small practical step, offer concrete example of action steps. Yeah, I think it's clear enough. And then still choosing the words, we have to limit the use of jargon, technical or scientific language, because it's quite hard to understand. And jargon actually, it can be put, but sometimes people take it differently. So that's why here they suggest to limit the use of jargon. But if the jargon is easy to understand, yeah, for example, it's an apple a day keeps the doctors away. That's the example, the use of jargon that is easy to understand means that if you take one fruit in a day, then you can it can prevent you from many kind of diseases. Okay, and also limit use of statistic. Use general words, of course. Statistic can be very, very confusing. Even for us as academician, it is confusing. Yeah, so limit the use of it. Limit the use of symbols, especially if it's not familiar. Choose word with a single definition, yeah, to prevent the misunderstanding. Be consistent with the word use. Yeah, because if you use many synonyms, it might also confusing for the audience. Use analogies familiar to your audience. It is also important, especially if your audience are children, because yeah, they are children. They don't know many things. Yeah, so using analogies can be helpful for you as a nutrition educators. Also, avoid synonym, avoid unnecessary abbreviation or acronyms. That's the message should be. And the last three, I think it's the last three. You can also include visuals to help explain the message. I think it is very appropriate for children and adolescents group, yeah. Because visual is more compelling, it's more interesting rather than just using words. Information is also segmented using headings, subheadings, and bullet lists. If there are any lists you want to put, but most importantly, you have to put the most important thing as the headings. Yeah, or maybe you can use different colors, yeah, or bold, many others. Then action step or desired behaviors for the audience should also be clearly stated. Here's the example, yeah, of the nutrition message. Very common now. I think we have seen this many times, especially during this pandemic, how to wash your hands, yeah. So there's a step by step, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I have to ask you, which one do you think is better? The left one or the right one? Anyone? The right
one.
Yeah. Ayn? Right one. You wanna answer?
The right one.
This one? Why?
Yes.
Why is it better?
Because it's clear the directions. Okay. The picture
is clear, the direction is clear compared to the left one, yeah. Okay, thank you, Ayn.
Yeah.
Anyone? Maybe you have a different idea. Think that the left one is better.
The right one.
The right one as well. This one,
because it shows until the last step, which is dry hand by using a towel.
Okay.
A dryer.
Yeah, it's very they use simple words. Yeah, they use pictures and then they put the hand movement, the right hand movement when you wash your hands. And then the steps also very clear to understand, easy to understand. And even they suggest you to turn off the tap using elbow or paper towel. Yeah, it's to eliminate or prevent the contamination after washing your hands. Okay, that's good. Okay, this is in Bahasa, but here's is the nutrition message for the clean and healthy behavior. Yeah, so we do have 10 messages from exclusive breastfeeding, and then using a clean water, washing hands, not smoking, doing the physical activity, and so on. I think Actually, this picture is also easy to understand, but just if I have a comments, it will be the picture. The picture is, you know, it's not entertaining. Yeah, it doesn't make me want to look at it. You know, it's because it's not interesting to me. Yeah, so I think it will be better if they can make the picture even better. Yeah, or maybe a more real gitu. Yeah. Okay, next one. Here's the example of the balanced nutrition. Yeah, it is very entertaining for children, as you can see here. Yeah, they use cartoons to describe that you have to eat all of this. Yeah, you have to eat variety of foods. You have to balance between food and fun. Yeah, so this is really interesting. I got this from choosemyplate.gov. It is from US. Yeah, it's very interesting. You can also, actually, if you are doing your assignment for the nutrition education, you can develop your own message, yeah, or your own material, your own poster, your own audio visual. It will be better. But if you don't have time, you can also choose from another site. But make sure that the site is it's from the reputable organization, yeah, not just from Google or something, but choose from the reputable organization. For example, like what I put here is from the US government. Yeah, and here's the left one. Fill half of your plate with fruits and veggies. It's actually a message that you have to fulfill your fruits and vegetable intake in a day. But it's a very simple message, yeah. Comparing to this, there are so many message that they try to say using this picture in the right one. Not only eating fruits and vegetable, but also grains, protein, and also don't forget dairy and physical activity here. Okay. Here the nutrition method for exclusive breastfeeding. Yeah, 10 steps to successful breastfeeding. Sorry, because the picture is not really clear. It's from UNICEF. It's also one of the most interactive poster I've ever seen, because it is colorful, but sadly the picture is blur and I think it's too small. Yeah, the text is too small, yeah, to understand. So in order to make it better, they actually can put only one or only maybe two or four picture, yeah, or two or four key message in one poster. So they can divide it into two or three poster, or they make the word shorter so that it is easier to be read by the audience. Okay, the next one, this is just short message. And here, yeah, message from the USDA again, to eat more fruits and vegetables. And I think there's a powerful message here. What kind of message that you think it is put here? It's actually the message that children behavior is actually shaping by parents' behavior. So children see, children do. That's what they are trying to say from this picture and from this message. Yeah, they learn from watching you. So if you want your children to eat fruits and vegetable regularly, then you have to eat fruits and vegetable also regularly. Yeah, that's the message, the nutrition message that we can obtain from this poster. And here is also an easy message. Yeah, make 5-2-1-0, your goal every day. 5 more fruit and vegetable, 2 hours recreational screen time, 1 hour physical, 1 hour or more physical activity, and 0 sugary drinks, more water and low fat milk. Yeah, this is very simple yet meaningful nutrition message. So talking about the effective message, there are several indicators. Yeah, aside from the FAO definition, the effective message should also be concise, active, positive, short, and specific. The positive here, I think this can be vary or your understanding between our understanding might be different. There's a one study that I can tell you. Most of the people, sometimes they are confused, yeah, or they lower their motivation. I mean, the motivation will be lower if they see a negative message in nutrition education. So just like when we are child, if I might say, for example, if your parents say you cannot do that, but instead of not doing that, we are doing the things, right? Like, don't watch television, but we watch television. Or we, for example, you don't eat that, but we want to eat that. It is also happened in nutrition education, actually. So don't put too much negative, like, don't eat that, don't eat this, because it will lower their motivation. So instead of using the terms of don'ts, you can either use more positive words, and more encouraging words, more motivational words, yeah, rather than just ask them to not doing or not eating something bad. Okay. And here are the communication channels that you can choose for doing your nutrition education, also for your assignment. Yeah, you can use social media. It is now widely available. And if I can ask you a question, what kind of social media that is, you know, most viral in your country? In Malaysia maybe, or Philippines, or can you tell me?
Facebook.
Oh, Facebook. Nice.
Twitter.
Oh.
Depend on each range. Like 40 and above, they prefer Facebook, and 30 and below, they prefer Instagram, Twitter, something like that.
Oh, yeah. I see. Yeah. It is also here in Indonesia. Yeah. It depends on the age group. So I think you can now decide, like, if you want to give a nutrition education for 40 years old up, then you have to use Facebook instead of Instagram, because less of them use Instagram and Twitter, right? Yeah. So you can use the social media for short messages, snippets of contents, graphic content, or two-way communication. Now even in Facebook, you can have a live, right? Live video, if I'm not mistaken. Something similar to Instagram Live, but it's Facebook Live. Yeah, so it's easy to organize there. And you can also use a printed material for static content, visual content. And the positive things about the printed material is it is reproducible content. So you can gain more participants, you can gain more audience using the printed material. For example, handout, brochure, poster, or infographic. Digital content, I'm sure you guys are very very good in creating a content, yeah, especially digital content for dynamic content, how to tutorials, information available on the go. Now TikTok is one of the most famous platform that you can use to educate audience, especially children and adolescents, yeah, with the highest use of TikTok. You can also use Facebook if you want. Website and blog post, I think it's an old one, yeah. It's not really, we don't really use it right now. And the last one, you can also use mass media, but mass media usually used for a large scale of public health campaigns, such as radio, TV, newspaper, news website, and many others. Okay, so last one, I think this is the last two slides, is related with the motivation. So if I previously said, like, if you want your audience to be more engaging, like engaged to what you are trying to say, then it is important for you to be able to motivate them. Yeah, motivate them means that we focus on actually what's in it for me. So you try to make them aware or on the nutrition issue that they might have. Yeah, for example, in the obese population or obese adolescent, some of adolescents think that that big is beautiful. They don't aware that the obesity might bring negative effects on their health and others, right? So your message is not just pointing out that the obesity is dangerous, it is not good for their longer health and many other negative effects, but it is important also to put the message that can motivate them, that can increase their awareness that, okay, I'm obese and I need to take steps because it's not good for me to have or to keep this obesity. So that's meaning of the motivation. So it is important also for us as nutrition education, not just able to develop the message, but also to motivate our audience to start changing their bad behavior to be a better behavior. Because if they're aware, then they will take an action. Yeah, here's, I write here, individuals make change when they see the need to change. When they contemplated changes, such as other deeper values they have, and when they want to change, yeah. So they see that I need to change my behavior, and I want to change the behavior. So that's the motivation that you need to arise during the nutrition education. However, motivation is quite hard to measure, yeah. Quite hard to measure compared to the cognitive or affective or psychomotor domain. Here's some example that might motivate the audience. It's like you really love yourself. Yeah, so it is motivate. I think, at least to me, it is motivating because, yeah, if I love myself, then I have to eat better. I have to fulfill the nutrient needs for my body and so on. So I will reduce the consumption of fat, of fat food, of sugary drinks, beverage, and so on. Yeah. And the right one is also motivating, actually. Yeah, it's also motivating, but in a scare tactic, but using scare tactic. Yeah. Smoking causes throat cancer. So it's a motivation to stop smoking in order to prevent you from cancer or even from death. Yeah, so many other countries now using this, what do you call this? Like warning picture, yeah. Okay. The last one, I'm sorry, I have to give you an assignment, but actually, this assignment will be beneficial for your final assignment for your nutrition education session, yeah. So you can first develop this, yeah. So what's your education and plan title? Who are the participants? And then what kind of goals that you want to achieve? Remember that goals should be broad, yeah. So not too specific, just maybe healthy diets or increased fruits and vegetable intake and many others. And then you can put the objective here, learning domain level, whether it is cognitive, affective, or psychomotor. And then what kind of communication channels that you are planning to do and what kind of message that you want to deliver to your audience. Okay, so if I'm not mistaken, again, this is a group work, yeah. The nutrition education assignment, the last assignment, final assignment is the group work. So you can also do this in a group as a group. Okay.
Madam,
yes.
We should give only one example, and what about the objective? Because there's a lot of table.
Oh, yeah. Okay, for one nutrition education, you can put at least one objective. At least one objective. If you have more, then you can put it all. But if you have only one objective, then just put one objective.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. So no need to be in rush. Yeah. You can submit it together with the last assignment. So don't worry. I understand that student must have a lot of paper to do. Okay, so you still have maybe 4 to 5 weeks to finish this and also to develop your last assignment, to develop your nutrition education session. Okay. Any more questions? Because I think this is the end of my slides. So I hope you can understand what I'm trying to say. Sorry for bad English. Okay, I will stop sharing here. Okay, so if there's no more questions, I can end this session. Thank you everyone for your attending, for your cooperation and for active participation. So I think we will meet again next week in another topic. So that's all. Good evening and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Miss Nita.
Thank you.
Thank you.